James Shirley, a famous Elizabethan poet, wrote the poem Death the Leveler. This poem was appropriately titled by James Shirley. The title, Death the Leveler, implies that death has the power to equalize everyone. Everyone is equal in the face of death. Nobody can escape the clutches of death. Death places no value on one's wealth, accomplishments, positions, or status. That is why the poet refers to death as a leveler. In the first stanza, James Shirley declares that death is unconcerned about whether a person comes from an aristocratic or royal family, as well as one's position, status, and achievement. These are fleeting and insignificant things. Nobody can escape the clutches of fate. The armor that protects a king or a soldier from an attack is rendered ineffective in the face of fate. Both kings and farmers are killed by death. Death makes no distinctions based on any criteria. One day, everyone will die and turn to dust. The poet associates kings with scepter and crown, and farmers with scythe and spade in this poem. The poet tells us in the second stanza that people with power can accomplish a lot. For example, kings wielding swords will conquer new lands. He will assert his authority over the newly conquered territory. Sometimes, in order to achieve victory, kings must kill some men. No matter how powerful they are, they will die sooner or later. Death cannot be defeated with their swords. They eventually become powerless, similar to a prisoner who is imprisoned. In the third stanza, the poet says that even if a man boasts about his mighty deeds, achievements, and rewards throughout his life, those will vanish once he leaves this world. Death is unconcerned about these. When confronted with death, even the greatest victorious man becomes a victim. He will not be able to defeat death. In the end, everything becomes a part of the earth and turns into dust. According to the poet, what remains are one's good actions throughout one's life. Even if a person is buried in a cold tomb, his actions will be remembered by others. As a result, his actions will bring him fame. As the poem concludes, we see an image of a lamb speaking to an altar in preparation for making a sacrifice to please the gods. Pagans are the ones who usually perform this type of ritual. The sacrificial lamb has no idea it will die soon. According to the poem, the man will also give his life in front of death's purple altar.